In the previous lecture, we have looked at the basic color elements according to the HSV color model. In this lecture, we will look at the RGB color model. RGB stands for red, green and blue. It is the color model that a digital camera uses, as well as your computer screen. An image from a digital camera is built up in three colors: red, green and blue. This means that each pixel of the image has information about how much red, how much green and how much blue it contains. I will click on the foreground color to open the color window. On the top we see the RGB color model. And when I click at the top right on HSV, we also get to see the HSV color model we have looked at in the previous lecture. With the three RGB sliders, you're able to make the same colors as you can with the three HSV sliders, as we will see at the end of this lecture. Right now, we have the color black, which indicates that the red, green and blue sliders don't have any value. They are all at 0%. With the sliders, we can change the red, green and blue values. Let's drag the red slider all the way to the right, to 100%. Next to current, we can see we now have full red. Now let's also drag the green slider all the way to the right. The result is that we see yellow. The color yellow is somewhat counterintuitive, because we are used mixing paint on paper, and mixing red and green doesn't make yellow. The answer lies in the term additive versus subtractive color. Let's open RGB color. RGB is an additive color system. In this image, we can see how it works. The image represents a fully unilluminated white wall, which is illuminated by three colored flashlights. Where two flashlights overlap, the color changes, and the wall gets brightened up even more. In the middle, where the red, green and blue flashlights all overlap, we are now able to see the wall as it is, in white. This is how the RGB color model works. The white wall is made visible by adding colored light, hence the name additive color. When we print an image on paper, what the paint will do is make the already white and illuminated paper darker, hence the name subtractive color. So additive and subtractive color work in opposite ways. As said, a digital camera works with the RGB color model. This means a digital camera will capture three images. When we lay these three images on top of each other, we see full color. Gimp and Photoshop will show us these three images in the panel at the right side of the Layers panel, called Channels. Here we have the red, the green and the blue image, in Gimp and Photoshop called Channels. They are black and white. I will click on the Configure tab to make the preview bigger. As I can hide layers, I can also hide channels. Let's hide the green and blue channel. Now I only see the red channel, which is the red information of the image. We can now see how much red there is in the image. Now let's recreate the yellow we had in the color panel by turning on the green flashlight. Here we also see that red light plus green light makes yellow light. Now open U-ring. The color ring shows us all U's, but is made up from just three basic colors: blue, green and red. If I add green, we see yellow appearing. And if I add blue, we also get cyan and magenta. As we can see, all hues can be created with just three basic colors. Our brain will mix these colors and we see color. Let's go back to the color window. If we now also add maximum blue, we will get white, just like where the three flashlights come together. To find a certain color, you can drag your mouse in the color square at the left. Here we see a horizontal line and a vertical line. The vertical line is the saturation. Dragging saturation down will desaturate the color. Dragging saturation up will increase the saturation of the color. The horizontal line is value. Moving value to the left makes the color darker. Moving it to the right makes the color lighter. At the right side of the square, we have the hue strip. You can slide through the hues by dragging. When you found a new color, you can add colors to the color history by clicking on the arrow button. The color history has room for 12 colors. When a new color is added, the existing colors shift one place to the right, and the oldest color at the bottom right will be deleted. If you need the HTML or hexadecimal notation of a color for the internet, you can copy it from here. In the next lecture, we will look at how to make images darker and lighter with levels.